This is pretty important to me and to the state of Montana, and I think to the nation. This is in support of S 255. What is it? It's a North Fork Watershed Protection Act. Let me read you a quote from John Muir, which I think applies. He said, "Everybody needs beauty as well as bread. Places to play in and pray in, where nature may heal and cheer and give strength to body and soul alike." This is one of those places. It's a very, very special place. Now, I know all members of this committee have special places in their home states. Some of them are beaches, mountains, plains, whatever they might be. For us in Montana, we have several ourselves, but this is one of them. This is pretty high up there. When I first came to the House a few years ago, 30-some years ago, I immediately realized that one of my major efforts is going to be to protect what's called the North Fork of the Flathead River. The North Fork of the Flathead River begins up British Columbia, and it flows south of British Columbia, then into east alongside of Glacier National Park. As it flows south, Glacier Park would be to the east of it, into Flathead Lake. Flathead Lake is the largest natural freshwater lake west of the Mississippi. The largest. It's the largest natural freshwater lake west of the Mississippi. It's pristine. I don't know now, but for many, many years, it's drinkable. You can drink the water in Flathead Lake. It's that pristine. It's that clear. It's also the summer playground for a lot of Montanans, for a lot of people outside of Montana who come there in the summer. It's great skiing in the winter. It is really, really special. It's the most intact ecosystem of the contiguous United States. It's a wide gravel bed river, the North Fork of the Flathead, flows next to tall peaks from British Columbia into Montana, and as I said, feeds the largest natural freshwater lake west of Mississippi, that's Flathead Lake. It drains snowmelt from places like Kintla Peak. This, on this photograph over to my right, Kintla Peak is the tallest peak. Kintla Peak is a Glacier National Park. Many times I've backpacked in the summers, crossed Glacier National Park, 4 or 5 days hike, and Kintla Lake. There's upper Kintla is close by, and lower Kintla is just below. It's just one of the most special places that one could ever hope to see. It's like Alaska. It's very, very similar to many places in Alaska. And on the other side of the North Fork, runoff comes from many species of trees, larch, lodgepole, spruce trees, and again back into Glacier National Park. This drainage has the highest vascular plant diversity and the highest density of large carnivores in the lower 48. A little more in Alaska, in the lower 48, it has the largest population of large carnivores and vascular plant diversity. Silvertip grizzlies feed on huckleberries, buffalo berries in this same pristine valley. Native bull trout find cold water and clean gravel for their reds. When you float the North Fork, you're just stunned. It's so deep and it's so clear and it's running so fast. There's just so much water. It's hard to find words to describe it. It's the most important wildlife corridor along the Canadian border between the Great Plains and the Cascades. And Montanans, very many days, enjoy hunting and fishing there. Today, about 2 million people visit Glacier National Park every year. That's about $100 million in the economy. It supports 1,400 jobs. One day, several years ago, really dawned on me how important it was to protect this resource. It was in 1976, and I talked to a couple of scientists. One guy was named Jack Stanford, another's Rick Hauer, and explained to me how all the mining up in British Columbia, is coal mining up there, economic benefits staying in Canada, and some of this coal mine would be shipped across the ocean over to Canada as coking coal, but yet all the environmental degradation flowed south. It was water flowed south into Montana, and also air currents that flowed south into Montana. So what do? Without being too involved here, I put together something called a baseline data study to get the baseline data for the whole basin so we could know the effects, whether it's Canadian, whether it's Forest Service in the United States, whether it's tourism in the United States or the private sector operations. homeowners along the lake, and that baseline data has helped us realize what we have to do to protect this resource. Then what do? We went to the Canadians. So let's figure this out together, and did. And we signed a compact Montana did with British Columbia. So both British Columbia and Montana are working to protect. I realized if we're going to show the Canadians we're doing our part, the key here is to withdraw leases, oil and gas leases, in the National Forest there, I mentioned, just to the west of this river. Most of the leases are already voluntarily withdrawn. The oil companies have said, hey, we're not going to find oil and gas here. We've got a lot of better prospects out in other parts of the country, fracking, horizontal drilling, other parts of Montana, other parts of the country. We're not going to drill here. So they've voluntarily withdrawn. There are just a few acres left of national forest land, and this bill provides that those acres, that the bill provides that there are no future leases in the area. It doesn't pull the other leases out. It doesn't tell companies they got to leave. It just says no future oil and gas leases in the area. And as I said, or implied, there's very little acreage left here anyway, because most of the leases have already been withdrawn, the companies and have voluntarily withdrawn. So I just urge you, Mr. Chairman and the rest of the committee, to look very seriously at this. This bill is the one missing piece, given all the other efforts we've undertaken in roughly 30-some years. And I know what I'm next going to say applies to all of us. I was drawn to public service by the belief that each of us has a moral obligation, that when we leave this place, we're not here forever. When we leave this place, we leave it as good a shape or better shape than we found it. Each of us has that moral obligation. It's environmental, it's economic, it's political. That's because we're only here for a short period of time on this earth. And for me, this is one of those areas where we can be sure that we're leaving this place in good a shape, maybe in better shape because of the protections that we found it. It's not controversial. Chamber of Commerce supports it. Entire Montana congressional delegation supports it. There are two Democrats in the Senate, one Republican in the House. We all support it. And I just urge this committee to just help finish this one little piece, and that's going to show to Montanans and to all those who enjoy a Glacier National Park that, hey, we're doing something that makes sense here. And I strongly urge the committee's support for this legislation.